آية نمبر 192 سورة آل عمران، the end of سورة آل عمران. As we mentioned before the last class, this ayat, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم read this ayat before قيام الليل, and he recited this ayat before making the wudu. And we mentioned this is a proof that it is allowed to read the Quran without wudu. Okay, read Quran without wudu. We are not talking about to touch the Mus'haf. We are talking about reading the Quran. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he woke up, he wiped his face with his hands without water. Then he recited this ayat and then he made the wudu and يعني he prayed قيام الليل 13 ركعة 13 ركعة 1-3. Another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one night was with Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. It was the night of Aisha. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Aisha, darini yata'abbad li rabbi, leave me to worship my Lord. He means to make qiyam al-layl. Then she said, O Rasulullah, by Allah, I love you and I love to be with you and I love to be close to you. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started to pray, and he was crying during the salah. She said, until he make his beard wet, and he continued his salah, and he was crying, and he made his, يعني, his lips wet because the tears were coming down. Then the ground that he was crying sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the tears were on the ground, and also it was wet under him. Then Bilal came to him and. يعني he noticed him صلى الله عليه وسلم crying like that and he said Allah forgave your sins. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said woe to those who read these ayat without thinking, without reflecting, without making reasoning about this ayat إن في خلق السماوات والأرض. So these are great ayat, the last 11 ayah from سورة آل عمران. طيب آية نمبر 192 يعني there are دعاء from the believers الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا. الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned the previous ayah last week 191. What they do, they make dhikr while sitting, walking, in any way. As the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Aisha رضي الله تعالى said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to make dhikr in any way. كان يذكر الله على كل أحيان. Okay, he's traveling, he's at home, he's riding his camel, he was making dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned what the believers are saying in their dua. So the first dua, previous ayah, 191, Rabbana subhanaka faqina adab al-nar, protect us from the punishment of the hellfire. The ayah today, رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ مَنْ تُدْخِلِ النَّارِ فَقَدْ أَخْزَيْتَهِ. Our Lord, indeed, whoever you admit to the fire, you have disgraced him. And for the wrongdoers, there are no helpers. So this is the real humiliation when the person lost himself in the hellfire. Because nowadays, it is a humiliation when people look at me and they don't give me salam. You feel bad. When people ignore you, you feel bad. This is a kind of humiliation. But the real loss, the real humiliation when you are in the hellfire wal-iyadu billah. So don't care about people in dunya if they ignore you. Okay, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, رُبَّ مَدْفُوعَ عَلَى الْأَبْوَابِ لَكِنْ لَوْ أَقْسَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ لَوْ أَبَرَّ. Okay, sometimes a person مَدْفُوعَ عَلَى الْأَبْوَابِ, if he tries to knock the door, talking to you, asking you something like this, okay, people push him. Okay, people reject him and يعني they shout him. Okay, he's nothing. But the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لكن لو أقسم على الله لا أبره. In the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this person, if he ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will answer him. So the real position where, in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this person is important, what we say nowadays, VIP. Okay, maybe he's kafir, he's a disbeliever, he's a tyrant, he's an arrogant. Okay, but in dunya, VIP, he pays money, people respect him, but at the day of judgment, he's nothing. He's nothing, subhanAllah. You should work to be a VIP at the Day of Judgment. Okay? How to be a VIP at the Day of Judgment? Those who walk quickly on the Sirat, those who stay under the shade of the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are VIP. Those who enter Jannah without punishment, without reckoning, they are the VIP. So don't feel, I don't say you feel bad, but subhanAllah, when you look at people, okay, with the luxury car, okay, when you go the flight, they are, okay, when you enter, you go to the right and they go to the left, okay? You like to know what is there, huh? You don't want to stay there, you like to know what is there, صح? Okay, but they put the curtain, you cannot see what is there. This is a different life. Okay, this is subhanAllah, the human being. You should think what people in Firdaus al-A'la, what they are getting there. Okay, think, okay, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's the only one will be in a place in Firdaus al-A'la, very high. Think what he will get there, alayhi salatu wa salam. Okay, how to be with him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. طيب أنا وكافي اليتيم في الجنة كآتين. If you take care of the orphans, you'll be with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let's think about the Akhirah. Okay, forget the dunya. Now we think only about the dunya, okay? How to make business, bitcoins, cars, food, everything dunya. What about the akhirah? Allah Kareem, Allah Ghafoor Rahim, Allah will forgive. This is the akhirah. But the dunya, you should work hard for everything in dunya. To earn money, get a nice job, wife, children, everything, subhanAllah. So they say in their dua, رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ مَنْ تُدْخِلِ النَّارِ فَقَدْ أَخْزَيْتَهِ وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ خِزِي. Okay, والعار, يعني it is like a shame. Those who enter the hellfire, subhanAllah. وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ. Okay, the wrongdoers, no supporters for them. Who can support the wrongdoers? Who can support those people in the hellfire because of their deeds? No. Dunya, yes. Okay, those who do crimes, they pay money for the lawyers, خلاص. They bring false paper, okay, witnesses, very easy, pay them, okay, 1,000 dinar, 2,000 dinar, خلاص, they will do 2-3 witnesses, easy. But this is in dunya, this is possible in dunya. In the akhirah, this is impossible. In the Akhirah, you pay me people some money and they will witness, oh Allah, this man was Hafid Quran. This is useless. This is not possible the Day of Akhirah. Even if you bring like this witness, your skin will talk, your thighs, your limbs. Okay. They will lie? They will not lie. They will tell the truth. Okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will close the mouth of this person and his limbs, his organs will speak. Subhanallah. So this is very important. وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ. No supporters for the wrongdoers. The next ayah, رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا سَمِعْنَا مُنَادِيًا يُنَادِي لِلْإِيمَانِ أَنْ آمِنُوا بِرَبِّكُمْ فَآمَنَّا. Our Lord, indeed, we have heard a caller. Okay. Calling to faith, saying, believe in your Lord, and we have believed. Okay, what is the meaning? إِنَّنَا سَمِعْنَا مُنَادِيًا. Okay, يعني the scholars say, or most of the scholars say, it means this ayah, the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. So what you feel without hesitation. Okay, this is like an advantage. When you hear the haq and you listen to the haq, you follow the haq immediately. Okay, some people, don't listen to them immediately. Give some time. Tell them tomorrow. You know, some people, what is their way? Number one, you should say no. Why? Because to prove that you have a personality. Because if you say yes immediately, this means you don't understand. You don't have a strong personality. At the beginning, you should say no or tell them tomorrow. Habibi, if someone shows you the haq, follow it immediately. It is from your wife, from your son, from your enemy. Follow the haq. So what you notice here? رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا سَمِعْنَا. Okay? Munadi. So, and also this is an important point that يعني you hear directly. You have an authentic information. This is very important, something authentic. It is not doubt, it is not fabricated hadith. Okay. سمعنا. Okay. What does that mean? يعني even when you study the hadith, okay, when the scholar says, I heard, سمعت, خلاص, it means direct. Like now, I speak and you are hearing me. Okay, خلاص, you are sure. It is not, it was said about you. No, we heard, we are sure. ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان. Okay, أن آمنوا بربكم. Okay, believe in your Lord. This is not something illogic. This is logic, and this is everyone agreed on that Allah Subhanahu wa Taala is the Creator. Okay, يعني usually the scholars say no one denies that Allah is not the Lord. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, even if some people, they deny verbally, but their hearts believe. Even Fir'aun, the most tyrant man, he believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Musa said to Fir'aun, قَالَ لَقَدْ عَلِمْتَ. Musa said, عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَسَلَامُ to Fir'aun, you know, عَلِمْت. What's mean, علم? Knowledge. So you are sure that this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What you do not deny that because of arrogance, because of your chair. Okay, so the same thing we tell these people, okay, the atheist. By heart they believe. Okay, when they say, no, I don't believe in God, they are liars. Wallahi, they are liars. Don't believe that there is someone, don't believe in a God. It is impossible to find a sane person who is not worshipping anything. He said, I don't worship anything. This is impossible. It is a darura, it is a necessity that you worship something. Either you worship Allah or other than Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? So at the end you'll find them believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah is the creator, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, they will discuss. They are ready to write books. Okay, but what is inside the heart? There is a caller inside the heart. Okay, Allah is the creator. There is a creator. You cannot escape that. You cannot escape that. Even if you write books about atheism and you defend them, there is something inside the heart telling Allah is the creator. No one can deny this nature. رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا سَمِعْنَا مُنَادِيًا يُنَادِي لِلْإِيمَانِ أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا. Immediately, okay, if you notice, فآمنا, فاء. If you remember many times we mentioned what is the difference between ثم and فاء. Okay, maybe both of them, the translation then. Okay, but what is the difference between ثم and فاء? ثم, it means there is a time. We hear someone today and we believe tomorrow. But فآمنا immediately. فآمنا immediately. Okay, يعني as I said, the translation, maybe you'll find both of them then. But فا means immediately. فآمنا. And this is, as I said, this is an advantage when you believe in the حق immediately. But when you read the story of Nuh عليه الصلاة والسلام, these people who knew, and the messengers, they accused those who followed the prophets بادي الرأي. This kind of people who followed the prophets, who followed Nuh immediately, they are not thinking. Whatever you tell them, they follow. So this is like يعني a disadvantage. No, this is an advantage. When you, of course, if someone tells you anything and you follow him, this is wrong. What Nuh عليه الصلاة والسلام told them, the logic, he told them the حق. Allah is the creator, obey him. And they followed. What's the problem with that? No, the people of Nuh, badi al-ra'i, they said. What is in badi al-ra'i? They don't have any kind of reasoning, any kind of thinking. As I said, and you know some people, no, wait, no, give me time. خلاص حبيبي it is clear. The haq is clear. Why you refuse? Why you delay? Follow the haq now. طيب فآمنا ربنا فاغفر لنا. If you notice here, they repeat in their dua what? ربنا. Okay, so one of the etiquettes of dua to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his name, الرب. الرب is one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أما الركوع فعظموا فيه الرب. In your ركوع, okay, what you do? You can glorify your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. We say, سبحان ربي العظيم. In the ركوع. سبوح قدوس رب الملائكة والروح. Okay. So in the ركوع, what you do? Glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. السجود, make a lot of دعاء. اللهم اغفر لي, اللهم ارحمني, اللهم اغفر لي ذنبي كله, دقه وجله, أول وآخر, علاني توسر. In the سجود, you do a lot of دعاء. In the سجود, الركوع, you glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, so use the name in your dua, use the name الرب. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسن وفي الآخرة حسن وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا ربي أعني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن. Repeat this name. If you notice, it is one dua, but they are repeating. So repeat in your dua. ربي اغفر لي خطيئتي وبالدين, ربي أعني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن, ربي شفيني أنت الشافي, ربي. Use the name رب. And this is called وسيلة. وسيلة. The scholars say there is an allowed wasila, okay, and there is not allowed wasila. What does it mean wasila? Wasila to reach somewhere. So to reach with your dua, to achieve your dua, you need wasila. What is your wasila? Use the names of Allah. This is one of the wasila. Rabbana, okay, or you use the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Rahman, irhamni. This is wasila by the names of Allah. يا غفور اغفر لي. Okay. يا شافي the curer شفيني. Okay. So you use, this is sunnah to use the wasila by the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what is the wasila they used? ربنا or اللهم. What is meaning of اللهم? Oh Allah, يا الله. So اللهم, you are using the greatest name, الاسم الأعظم. Okay. الاسم الأعظم الله. So when you say Allahumma, this means Oh Allah. طيب. So this is one of the wasila when you use the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also one of the wasila also they use in their dua. Okay, Rabbana faghfir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyatina. Sorry, the previous ayah, Rabbana innaka man tudkhili an-nara faqad akhzayta. Also this is a kind of wasila. When you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by his actions, what he can do subhanahu wa ta'ala, what he is doing subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani when you use or when you mention the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, يعني, like in dunya, طيب, if you like something from a king, okay, you mention some of his criteria, صح? You are wallahi generous, you are helping people. So لله المثل الأعلى. You are saying for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you put people in the hellfire, khalas. This is the greatest shame for them. So you use wasila in your dua, okay, when you praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they said, Rabbana faghfir lana dhunubana. Okay. Here they say in their dua, okay, our Lord, so forgive us our sins. What does it mean here? Our Lord, so forgive. What is the point here? Our Lord, forgive us our sins. No, it is our Lord, so forgive. Because this is related with the previous sentence. Yani, oh our Lord, because we believed when we hear the caller, the munadi, the messenger, so please forgive us. Okay, so this is also a wasila by your righteous deed. So they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive their sins because they believed in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is called التوسل بالعمل الصالح. التوسل بالعمل الصالح. You invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by using some of your righteous deeds. One deed, two, three, your deed, your righteous deed. Okay, and the scholars mentioned the famous story when the three people went inside the cave and the stone came and closed the door of this gate, the gate of this cave. So they agreed to do what? Or to say what? Yes, everyone should invoke Allah with a sincere deed. So everyone invoked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, I have two parents, I have two, my parents, I was giving them the food before my children. That day, and he mentioned one day, when he ignored his children, waiting his parents. Sah? So, oh Allah, if you know that I did that for your sake, okay, open the door for us. So the stone moved shwaya, little bit. The second one, he said, oh Allah, you know that there was a woman, I love her too much, but I left her for the sake of Allah. I was going to do the haram, the adultery with her, but I stopped that for your sake, for the sake of Allah. Sincere deed. No one with them. Okay, so he left the haram, the fahisha, the sin, for the sake of Allah. And the third one, okay, when he grow the money of like his employee. So they invoked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by a righteous deed. And the scholars, when they mention this story, they say, what about if you are the fourth one? Do you have a dua? Sorry, do you have a sincere deed to make the to open the door for them? Or they will be inside the cave forever. So we should, there is a saying by one of the companions, I'm not sure, maybe Mu'adh radiallahu ta'ala, لِيَكُنْ لِيَحَدِكُمْ خِبْءُ عَمَلٍ صَالِحٍ. Let for you, يعني, a hidden, okay, of a sincere deed, sincere righteous deed. Do something, but not publicly. Don't do everything publicly. Let's have something hidden. Even your wife doesn't know about that. Not everything the media. You do anything. You feed a cat, selfie with the cat. Okay. You help the needy. Okay. Immediately you put in the Twitter. We went to that country and we helped them. Any deed, any righteous deed, you try to put this in CNN, BBC, corner, and everything. Let people know. And what? And the shaitan, okay, tells you, no, tell people, because if you tell people and people follow you, then Allah will reward you. Everything. Even Qiyam al-Layl. You are telling people you are doing Qiyam al-Layl. These people do also like me Qiyam al-Layl. Where is the ikhlas? Ikhlas is zero. So you should have something. And this is the challenge. Can you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone without telling anyone? Can you switch off your mobile and you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Can you stop your camera? Then you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Can you travel performing umrah, coming back without telling anyone? Why everyone should know where you are going, what you are eating, what you are saying? Shunada. The camera, 24 hours. No, let's have something. Not everything. Something, khalas, between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanAllah, when you read about this issue, يعني some scholars, يعني you'll find them hiding their deeds even from their wives. Even the wife who is sleeping with him doesn't know what he's doing. Doesn't know he's crying for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or because of reading Quran. Okay? يعني, I don't mean that يعني you force yourself that
يعني you know sometimes your wife, خلاص your wife with you at home. Is it compulsory to hide my deeds from my wife? I wait my wife to sleep then I pray. But if she's not sleeping I don't pray. No, we don't mean that. Okay? But your main concern should be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the the proof that you are sincere? Okay, what is the sign of your sincerity? People there, people not there, for me the same. Then you are sincere. But if your deeds are different, I am alone, shwaya, very little deeds, with people, too much deeds, you have a problem with your heart. You have a problem, riya, show off. So this is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, والتوسل بالعمل الصالح. You ask Allah, oh Allah, I did yesterday, I gave my money, half of my salary, to a needy family. And no one knows this except you. You can ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, with your righteous deed. This is الوسيلة. This is a kind of وسيلة also. ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا. طيب. Our Lord, so forgive us our sins and remove from us our misdeeds. طيب. If you notice here, ذنوب سيئات. Some scholars said, what is the difference between dunub, sayyat? They come together. This is generally, when I say, this is dhamb, it is a sin. This is sayyat. Okay? Yani also a sin, generally speaking. But now they are together in one ayah. So in Arabic language, if they are mentioned in one place, so for sure they are different in meaning. Okay? If they are mentioned in one place, so they are different, they have different meaning. So some scholars said, dhunub means major sins. Sayyat means, here, minor sins. The ayah means that رَبَّنَا فَغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا وَكَفِّرْ عَنَّا سَيِّئَاتِنَا. Oh Allah, forgive the major sins and also the minor sins. Another opinion that الذنوب means the previous sins. And the sayyat, what we are going to do in the future. Third opinion, that dhunub means the sins في حق الله سبحانه وتعالى, يعني what is between you and Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Yeah, for example, if you miss the salah, okay, this is a sin. This is the right of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. But if you steal from someone, this is from another person. Yeah, this is the right of people. So if the sin, the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is dhanb. If it is the right of people, this is sayyi'ah. And also, fourth opinion, dhanb means what the man or what the slave is doing that intentionally. I know drinking wine is haram, so I drink the wine. This is haram, this is dhanb. Okay? Sayyi'ah, doing this kind of transaction and you don't know it is riba. You don't know this way of transaction, this bank, it is riba, you don't know. So you are doing this. This is sayyah. So you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's why we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مَا عَلِمْنَا مِنْهُ وَمَا لَمْ نَعْلَمْ. Oh Allah, forgive us our sins, what we know and what we don't know. Okay, because sometimes we do sins and we don't know. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins. طيب ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا. طيب فاغفر المغفرة, okay, to cover. يغفر, as translation they say forgive, but originally what is the meaning of مغفرة؟ غفر, to cover, okay, يعني also the blanket, we call it the cover. In Kuwait, we use the term the cover, the blanket. Why? Because it covers us. Okay? المغفر, what does it mean, مغفر?
the head shield for those who go fight jihad, okay, or if there is a war. So there is something mighfar to cover the fighter. Mighfar, it covers the body or the head. This is mighfar. So I mean, the origin word of maghfira is covering. Okay, so what is the relationship between covering? To cover the sin. This is a sin. Okay, or this is the sin, so you cover it. خلاص. If you cover the sin, it is not there. So we ask Allah, oh Allah, cover our sins. Because if they are exposed, it is shame for us. And it is sin for us. It makes us feel very bad. And also, it can take us to the hellfire. So, oh Allah, cover that. And yeah, there is a common issue that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Ghafoor and Al-Ghaffar. These two names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Ghafoor, Al-Ghaffar. And also Allah is Al-Afu. Al-Afu. Al-Afu from the meaning of Al-Afu. Ya'fu means to erase. To erase. You write something, okay, then you erase it. It was there. Then it is not here. Afu. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يغفر الذنوب ويعفو. Okay? So yeah, sometimes you find the scholars, which is stronger, maghfirah, to cover or to erase? You'll find some scholars say, we need both of them, of course. We need both of them. Okay, we need maghfirah and also we need afu. We need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cover our sins and also to erase them. طيب. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to erase our sins and also to cover them, both. يعني the famous dua of ليلة القدر, اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعفو عنا. Okay, اللهم إنك the dua اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو. Some people add اللهم إنك عفو كريم. The word كريم, it is not in the hadith. The word كريم, it is not in the hadith. The hadith, the authentic hadith, I mean, اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعفو عنا. Okay. So we need العفو and also we need المغفرة. We need العفو and we need المغفرة. طيب فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. Here Allah سبحانه وتعالى says about their dua and cause us to die with the righteous. So they are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way of death. They are not asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the death. Because asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the death, this is okay, not allowed. Not allowed. Okay, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah make me to cause me to die now. This is haram. Don't ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the death. But yani, some people confuse, but they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here. And also dua of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, tawaffani musliman walhiqni bis-salihin. Okay, the Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, and also the believers here, they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way how to die. They are not asking Allah to die now. They are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we die, let's be with the abrar, the righteous. And Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam said, tawaffani musliman, oh Allah, when I die, let me die as Muslim. So it is okay to ask Allah, and this is good. We need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to die as Muslims. Allahumma tawaffani musliman walhiqni bis-salihin. When I die as a Muslim, as a mu'min, as a believer. Okay, but you ask Allah, oh Allah, I want to die now. I want to finish my life now. Okay, it is يعني, I have disease, I have this, it is painful, my family. No, this is haram. You have to be patient. You have to be patient. So they say in their dua, and cause us to die with the righteous. And also, what is the meaning of that? It means that you should work hard to be with the good people in dunya. If you are with good people in dunya, inshallah, you'll be with them in the akhirah. The good friends. The good friends. This is one of the يعني, best things. This is very helpful. Very helpful. So, يعني, don't try, يعني,
stay alone in your life. You know, some people say, you tell them to come to the halqa. Okay. I sit at home, okay, I watch the class online with my coffee, with my tea. No headache. And subhanAllah, sometimes people think this is wasting time when you go to your friends and Habibi, yani, wasting time when you stay with the shaitan at home. Okay, the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّمَا يَأْكُلُ الذَّأْمِنَ الْغَنَمِ الْقَاسِيَةِ. Okay, if there is a herd of sheep, okay, the wolf waiting. Why? Because he wants one sheep, one to go here or there, then he will attack. But the herd together, and the shepherd, and the dog, he will not approach. The shaitan like that. We are together, okay, we are reading the Quran, making tafsir, we have our activities together, okay. The shaitan will be away. He's waiting. One of us to go alone. Why you are wasting your time with your friends? شنو هذا؟ Okay, you drive to the class. You are waiting the sheikh. You are, Habibi, use your time. Stay at home, listen to the lecture alone. You will do this 1 week, 2 weeks, then, okay, خلاص. You will watch a movie. You are alone with the shaitan. SubhanAllah, the Sharia doesn't want the person to be alone. Okay, I mean generally, be in a group. In traveling, الراكب شيطان, الراكبان شيطانان, الثلاثة ركب. About traveling, when you travel alone, this is shaitan. Two, also shaitan. Three, this is okay. Okay, some people think that when I travel alone, plane, Sheikh, this is allowed. I'm Habibi. The hadith means you are traveling alone. You are, yeah, for example, you are walking the desert alone. But in the plane, there are 200, 300 people. This you are alone from, yani, not with your friends, not your with your family. Okay, but this doesn't mean that you are alone. Yani, if you are driving this car alone in the desert, no one in the desert, don't do it alone. Okay, so try your best to always to be in a group. The salah, jama'ah. Okay, you'll find the hadith, pray the jama'ah, the fard, in jama'ah, congregation. It's very important to be in the jama'ah. If you notice, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "مجتمعه قوم في بيت من بيوت الله يتلون كتاب الله." Okay, if there is any group, okay, he said, "مجتمعه قوم." What does it mean? قوم? Group of people, group of men. في بيت من بيوت الله. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not say, "ما جلس رجل," a man did not sit alone, and no, a group. So try your best to be in a group. Why? Because this will encourage you. This will encourage you. Okay? But imagine if every one of us in his masjid, every Saturday, please brothers, every Saturday, where's your masjid? Salmiya? Alas, you stay in Salmiya. You open the tafsir and you read the tafsir. And I am here in Mishrif alone. And you are in Salwa. And you are in Subah Salam. Everyone alone. Yalla, you open the tafsir. Alas, and I check after 1 year. Okay? How many surah you finish? After 1 year, maybe your mobile, you change your mobile, you are not in Kuwait. Ugh. Difficult to keep reading the Quran alone. يعني. I mean, to do the halqa alone. So this is very important. So please, يعني, the brothers who are thinking, يعني, I know some brothers like that. They don't يعني, it doesn't have a value to be with the friends. They consider this as wasting, assuming this as wasting time. No, Allah, this is not wasting time when you are with your friends. Okay, yes, يعني before the halqa, maybe there is some time for chatting. After the halqa, there is dinner, there is breakfast. But this should be the life, to be social. Okay, this is something, this is what is normal. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam can sit at home doing qiyam al-layl, he praying the whole day. He can do that. He can pray from morning until night, until Fajr. But the Prophet ﷺ provided himself for people. Yes, sometimes for the ibadah night prayer, but sometimes for people, sometimes for friends, sometimes for family. This is very important to give it time fi sabilillah. And also this is a protection. This is the protection when you are with friends. Because if I am with friends, I do something wrong, they correct me. There is something good, they encourage me. But of course, good friends, not any friend. Good friends. Okay, the friends who are in the masjid, friends talking about the Quran, talking about the hadith, the seerah. طيب. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يعني their دعاء ربنا وآتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك. Our Lord, and grant us what you promised us through your messengers. ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد. And don't disgrace us on the day of resurrection. Indeed, you don't fail in your promise. Again, repeating the same tawassul, Rabbana, okay, one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَآتِنَا مَا وَعَدْتَنَا عَلَىٰ رُسُلِكَ. Okay, what you promise, you give us. So they believe in the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which means they have yaqeen. They have certainty. I believe, and I am 100% sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give the believers paradise. And this is true. Okay? I'm not doubt about my religion. I am sure. Which means the yaqeen. People say, how you believe in this? Do you believe that, wallah, there is a punishment in the grave? You believe in the angels? You know how the world, what angels? Jibreel, 600 wings, one wing will cover the whole horizon. You believe? Yes, I believe. If it is mentioned, I believe. See? And this is not easy, wallahi. This is not easy. But for the believers, alhamdulillah, very easy. But for those who, يعني, their brain are not clean, very difficult for them. That's why, subhanAllah, if you read the Quran, the Sunnah, then the iman, the faith will be very easy for you. But if you try to open books of non-Muslims, those who have doubts, don't approach them. No need for their books. You know, some people say, no, we should read what they are writing. Okay? You should be open-minded. Habibi, this is your brain. Okay? You have children, and you tell your children, wallahi, this is water, orange juice, wine, poison, yalla. Yallah, this is life. You should try. You put your children at risk, then you are not a father, you are a snake, you are shaitan. You should protect your children, you should tell them, this is right, this is wrong. Okay, so don't expose your brain for anything. If you are a Muslim, you are a Muslim, yes, I am Muslim, khalas, I should read the Quran. And I should believe in the Quran. I should understand the Quran. You are Muslim? Read the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But subhanallah, you find many Muslims going here and there. Okay, they are reading many books except the Quran. Okay, يعني how many times, يعني when I discuss with friends, Muslims, okay, there is one writer here, one author there. Habib, did you read the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? No. If you are Muslim, read the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Try to understand the Quran. Okay, this is very important. This is your life. This is your soul, the Quran. This is your happiness, the Quran. But if you go here and there, wallahi, this psychologist, this counselor, this author, habibi, they need the Quran. They need the Quran. طيب. So, ربنا وآتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة. Okay, again, what they said in before to one ayah, before two ayah, رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ مَنْ تُدْخِلِ النَّارِ فَقَدْ أَخْزَيْتَ. They mentioned الخزي, like shame. And here, رَبَّنَا وَآتِنَا مَا عَتَنَا رُسُلِكَ وَلَا تُخْزِنَا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. So if you notice, they don't want the shame at the day of judgment. Okay, so in dunya, maybe something people consider this as shame. I want to cover my beard. I don't want people to see my beard. Let people see your beard. What's the problem? No, my dishdash, my thobe, my garment above the ankles. Wallah, I feel shame. Habibi, this is sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why you are feeling shame? Sunnah. Let people know the sunnah. Do the sunnah for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Use the siwak. No, this is shame. Habibi, what is the shame? The shame when you are in the hellfire at the day of judgment. Okay. ربنا إنك ربنا وأتينا ما أتانا رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد. You don't fail in your promise. Any one of us breaks his promise. Subhanallah. Why? I don't fulfill my promise because of I lie. I am human being. Or I cannot. I promise you. Next week, I will bring a VIP breakfast. Happy, huh? So, next week, I'm not here. I'm traveling. Where is Sheikh Ahmed? He skipped the breakfast. So, I did not fulfill my promise. Why? Maybe my wife shout me, so I. She said, "Why you promised your friends to this is halqa you bring to them food? Shinu hada?" So khalas, I'm sitting at home. I'm not coming. I'm sending you. Sorry, I'm sick today. People break the promise because they cannot, because they lie, because many things. But promise of Allah subhanahu wa taala. Okay, no one can stop the promise of Allah subhanahu wa taala. لا رد لقضائه. Anything, any decree of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. إنك لا تخلف الميعاد. Allah سبحانه وتعالى promises something, he will do it. If Allah سبحانه وتعالى promises that will give the victory for the believers, خلاص, this will happen. إن تنصر الله ينصركم. If you support the religion of Allah, Allah will support you. خلاص, this is a promise from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And they mentioned Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah in one of the battles. Okay, he was saying, we are going to defeat them. Khalas, we are, yani, the victory for us. They told him, yani, please say inshallah. Okay, he was sure. Why? Not because he was proud or arrogant. No, because we are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are following the religion of Allah. So Allah promised us, if we support the religion of Allah, he will support us. He will give us the victory. So, no doubt, the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will happen. إِنَّكَ مَنْ تُدْخِلِ النَّارَ Sorry, وَلَا تُخْزِنَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ إِنَّكَ لَا تُخْلِفُ الْمِيعَادِ إِنَّكَ لَا تُخْلِفُ الْمِيعَادِ InshaAllah, stop here. InshaAllah, next halqa will be the last halqa, inshaAllah, Surah Ali Imran. بسم الله. Any question?
What is the difference between تخلف الميعاد and يخلف الميعاد؟
تخلف and يخلف؟
Yeah.
تخلف you are talking, I'm talking to you. I say أنت. Okay, يخلف someone not here. Huh? Yes. But يخلف someone, I talk about someone not here. يعني when I ask Allah سبحانه oh Allah give me this أنت لا تخلف الميعاد oh Allah you don't break the promise but when I speak to you about Allah سميع trust Allah Allah لا يخلف so I'm telling you about Allah شنو هذا ضمير غائب what you call ضمير غائب in Arabic language huh in English يعني you third person you he
When I speak to you, ta. He, yeah. Yeah. Okay, you stop. One point, last week, Tuesday, I spoke about the seerah, and one brother asked me that he understood that I don't recommend to teach the books of seerah like Rahiq Makhtoum. My point is not to teach the seerah and teach Shama'il Muhammadiyya. My point was, when you teach the seerah, okay, let's start with the authentic information, because many things in the books of seerah not authentic or without reference. Okay, and I gave example, the name of Abu Bakr Abdullah Uthman, the name of Abu Hurairah Abdurrahman Sakhr. Okay, I don't mean don't name these things, but I mean don't put the priority for it. For example, you have once a week, or for example, you have a course for new Muslims, or for the brothers or sisters. Okay, this is the first time. 6 hours. Okay, so he spent 6 hours talking about the life before prophethood. Okay, now let's talk about the life before prophethood, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if there is authentic hadith, like when he was with Halima al-Sa'diyya, and the angels came and they opened his chest and they cleaned his chest, and they closed his chest again. This is authentic hadith. We teach this. When you come to al-Wahi, you mention hadith Aisha radiallahu ta'ala when the Prophet ﷺ was going to Ghar Hira. No, this is seerah. And we should know this. This is authentic hadith of Bukhari in the first chapter, Kitab Bid al-Wahi. Okay, you mention, for example, when the Prophet ﷺ started the da'wah, he went to the Jabal Mount of Safa, and he climbed the mount, and he called people, and he told them about the hellfire. Then Abu Lahab said, Tabbalak. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we mentioned this is seerah. So I mean, let's focus on the seerah, on the authentic hadith when you speak about seerah. And anything. Okay, about the other things, if you have, for example, second level, if you are a faculty of Sharia, you are a student of Sharia. So you are in the faculty of Sharia 5 years. Every day, 5-6 lectures. Okay, study the seerah in details. Spend maybe 80 hours to study the seerah. But if you have a group and you have very limited time, you have, for example, once a week or twice a week, and you focus on something, as I mentioned, some people, they, when they write a quiz, Islamic quiz, okay, you check most of the questions, not important. Or not authentic information, not authentic hadith. Okay, Habibi, you'll write 10 questions and you will distribute them and people will search. What was the name of the mother of Musa, alayhi salatu wasalam? What was the name of mother of Musa? Okay, go and search, you'll find something. Okay, but how much reward you will get if you know the name of the mother of Musa, alayhi salatu wasalam? Okay, or the brother of Yusuf, alayhi salatu wasalam? We need to teach them, for example, if you are going to do a quiz for students in the school, let's focus on something useful. What is the dua at the end of the salah? اللهم إني أعوذ بك من عذاب جهنم من عذاب القبر من فتنة محيى الممات شر فتنة المسيح الدجال or سبحانك اللهم بحمدك وتبارك اسمك. Okay. Give them something useful. Or if there is a name, authentic name, for example, I don't mean the name is not important. No, some names we need. For example, who is the companion called صاحب سر النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to give him the secrets. His secrets. حذيفة رضي الله تعالى عنه. This is common in the hadith. And Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه asked حذيفة about the names of the hypocrites. So, let's focus on something authentic
and useful. Authentic and useful. Yeah, especially because I'm teaching in English. And as you know, we have relatively, how many lectures in English here in Kuwait if you compare to the Arabic lectures? And it is not even less than 1% maybe. Yeah, for example, how many English khutbah in Kuwait? 3. How many Arabic khutbah in Kuwait? 2,000. Okay, I think 2,000 masajid in Kuwait, Arabic. And in English, only 3. So let's use the time in a proper way. If you are in the Sharia field, this is a different story. You study tafsir details. Maybe you spend 5 years in Surah Ali Imran. You take tafsir ibn al-Jawzi, and every ayah you take 6-5 opinions. If you are a student of tafsir, this is a different story. But for our tafsir, for example, no need to mention many opinions. وإياكم